Different today, I'm on site and not Matthew. Got an issue with my daughter's socket in her bedroom. This is a dry lined wall, so a hollow stud partition wall, and the dry line box behind it has failed. So we're going to have an investigate and see if Kaz can repair it. If I can't, you won't be watching this video, will you? So we're going to take off the socket front and have a look what the issue is. However, before we do so, we know it's vitally important to do the safe isolation procedure. Down at the consumer unit, I've locked off the circuit breaker, put a sign on, etc. I've shown the safe isolation procedure so many times on the channel, I'm not going to go through the full procedure now. However, just a word of warning, this is not a DIY video. It links to fitting a dry line box for my learners and the fact that we have to work safely in an installation. But we're going to investigate what the problem is. I've got my proving unit and my voltage indicator, so I am going to quickly do the safe isolation procedure, but not in any detail. It is not for that part of the video. It's to see and investigate what's gone wrong with the dry line box. So let's test this first. So if we take our approved voltage indicator, we know the tips must be no greater than 4 mil. We've got our proving unit, and I'm just going to plug it in like so and just prove that that works. If we just try and show that, okay, so we're in a position where we know that works. And we're going to use this now inside the socket outlet to prove it's dead before we investigate and work. I already know it's dead because I've already plugged in my plug-in voltage indicator, and we've got a video on the channel showing you how to use one of these, and you have to use it in one of your assessments. But today, I'm going to use this now as this part of the video. Okay, so it looks like one of the side supports is broken. Okay, so it's here, it's broken. So I'm going to whip off the front cover. It should be dead, but again, as always, we're going to prove it's dead. So we're going to whip off the front cover, like so. Still being careful in order that we don't touch anything. Longer screw than expected. There we go. So we popped it down, and straight away I can see the side section here has snapped off the box. So if we look at it, hopefully one that I can repair it with, this side flap just here. Okay, so we've got that side flap. I'm hoping it's just going to be a straight replacement in order to fix this. If it wasn't, I might have to take the whole entire box out if I didn't have the same manufacturer of side panel in order to clip it into here. So it could be a full box change. I'm hoping it isn't. I'm hoping this is going to be the same make. I'm not convinced it's going to be the same make, but we'll give it a go. So on further investigation, I've had a little look in here. It isn't this flap. So I've got the wrong box here out of my garage. But lucky old Gaz went into the garage and another box, and I believe that's the one we've got here. So these flaps, I'm going to replace both of them. This one's looking quite tired, this side as well. This one looks like it's going to save the day. Otherwise, it was going to be a complete box out. But before I do anything, I need to prove the terminals in here have been isolated before I work in the actual box itself. So if I go between the CPC first and line conductor, off the line conductor, onto the neutral conductor, off the neutral conductor, and then we go neutral conductor, line conductor, off the line conductor, off the neutral conductor, we've proved that it's dead almost. Okay, so we now need to reprove on our proving unit that it actually is dead. So back into our approved voltage indicator, into our proving unit, and we can see again that we've safely isolated that. So we know it's off. Down in the actual consumer unit itself, it's locked off, etc., and we're ready to go. But it was a longer process than that. Like I said, I used the plug-in voltage indicator and some other bits first. Right, so let's replace these flaps. So hoping Gaz has got the right screwdriver. Okay, so we'll see if we can get this one out first and foremost. So that was the broken one. So that one can come out. Always difficult when Joe's not. I've got no one to talk to. Got my daughter behind the camera. So that one's completely broken. So we've got that one's broken completely. I've never had that before, ever, that it's come off. So that's obviously been yanked in and out a few times. Well, the other one looks a bit runny ropey as well. So if I can get that one out, I will. Okay, so again, that one is bent beyond belief. So if they're the same, we should be able to take them out of this one with a bit of luck. So I've got that one out, push that one back, and we go again. Hopefully that one will pop straight out. Whoops, that one's out. And then see if I can get these back in correctly. So, and like so. That's that up. Okay, get them around the right way. Always a helpful tip there, get them in the right way around. So we were that way around. Okay. So I've in and replaced the two clips themselves. Yeah, straightforward job, okay, nothing difficult there. You know, it was a bit of luck that I had a replacement. Otherwise, you just got to take the socket front off, replace the entire box. So they're in, we can screw the front back on, and then we can re-energize the circuit. So that's it. So I just wanted to simply show that we had an issue with one of these side flaps. So the side flap is the part that's gripping against the actual dry lined box. So pop that one back in. This section here squeezes between the plasterboard, like so. So that's between the plasterboard, and obviously then pulls up as you screw your front on. It pulls and squeezes tightly against the plasterboard in order to secure it into place. So at the minute it feels like it's a little bit loose. It actually tightens on when you put the actual front screws in to grip. So I've replaced them, they're both broken. Socket outlet can go back on, and hopefully my daughter will be a little bit happier. So pop screws back on here and here. It did have a little bit of decorator's cork around it. I'm not a massive fan of decorator's cork around electrical outlets, but it's been done in the entire house. So I will go back and just put a little bit of decorator's cork in on the edges. I'll explain that in a sec. Just screw that one back on. This is where it isn't level and I can't see because I can't step backwards. And everybody will say, you never put it on level. So you can see how much you can tighten even though it's on, squeezing that up onto the plasterboard in order to grip. Okay, so that's in position. Normally they'd run a little bit of decorator's cork along here in the side edges before decorating. However, my daughter would like to say for the video, the pink walls are going. A decision made with 5-year-old girl in mind, and now I've got a 12-year-old girl, we're gonna have a different color. So this quick and easy video on how to replace the side flaps on a dry line box, or replace the box itself if you couldn't get instant replacements out of your garage like I did. We hope this video has been some help.